Good morning, students. Myself, Professor Jaspreet Kaur. Today, we will do the next topic of Chapter 1 of Mechanics. That is, we will find the expression for velocity using plane polar coordinate system. As you know, in the previous lecture, we have discussed the four types of coordinate systems, which were Cartesian coordinate system, plane polar coordinate system, spherical coordinate system, and cylindrical coordinate system. We discussed in the previous lecture all about Cartesian coordinate system. By using Cartesian coordinate system, we have derived the expression for position vector, displacement vector, velocity vector, and the acceleration. Now, today, I am going to start the next plane polar coordinate system, and by using these plane polar coordinates, we will derive the expression for velocity of a particle in plane polar coordinate system. Before I start the actual topic, that is derivation of velocity of a particle in plane polar coordinate system, you should know what is a plane polar coordinate system. So, a plane polar coordinate system is a two-dimensional coordinate system in which each point on a plane is determined or represented by a distance from a reference point and an angle from a reference direction. See the name plane polar coordinate system. Plane means we will use out of three coordinates, two coordinates. Now, polar coordinates we are using here, r and theta. Now, what is r? R is the radial distance of the point. Point means whose coordinates we are, whose position vector we are going to write. Radial distance of the point from the origin, let it to be represented by vector r. R is known as radial distance. Look here in the diagram. Let us suppose this is our two-dimensional coordinate system. Here we are taking the point P. Now the coordinates of point P at any instant, here we are writing it by r theta. R here is the distance joining this origin, that is the reference point, also known as pole, and the point. Now, r is known as radial distance of the point from the origin, O. And this r is, radial distance is always positive. Positive means taken in positive direction is OP. We can increase this positively upward direction. So R is always positive. The value of R, radial distance, varies from 0 to infinity. So these two points about the radial distance. R is always positive. Secondly, it can have value ranging from 0 to infinity. Now the second polar coordinate is theta. Angle. Now the angle which the r, radial distance, make with positive direction of x-axis. Positive direction of x-axis is this. The angle which the arc makes with positive direction of x-axis. Now this theta is measured in anti-clockwise direction with respect to line OX. With respect to line, this is my OX line. It is measured anti-clockwise. See the direction here, marked here arrow. This is anti. R theta is measured in anti-clockwise direction. Secondly, the value of theta ranges from 0 to 2 pi. Now let us write the values of R and theta, how we will write. Now see here, now let us suppose from P we dropped a perpendicular on x-axis PM. So we can write from here XOM is equal to distance x. X will be equal to R cos theta. In this right angle triangle OPM we can write X is equal to R cos theta and Y is equal to R sin theta and position vector R, as yesterday we have written in the previous lecture, R vector is equal to I cap X plus J cap Y, right? So we can write I cap X is R cos theta plus J cap R sin theta. Now R can be taken common, so I can write I cap cos theta, I cap cos theta and J cap sin theta. So vector R is given by R I cap cos theta plus J cap sin theta. So this is how the position vector R in plane polar coordinates can be written as I cap cos theta plus J cap sin theta. Now further, let us write the unit vectors. Now the unit vectors in plane polar coordinate system are E r cap and E theta cap, as we have already done Cartesian coordinate system. In Cartesian coordinate system, we were using I cap, J cap, K cap. The unit vectors along the x-axis, along the y-axis, along the z-axis, z direction. Similarly, ER cap is the unit vector in increasing directions of R. E theta cap is the unit vector in the increasing directions of theta. Now here in the diagram, see, I have marked here, this is the increasing directions of R, ER cap along this direction, E theta cap along this direction. Now ER cap can be written as you know, a unit vector A cap can be written as vector divided by its magnitude. Now similarly, I can write this ER cap. How I will write it? It will be equal to R vector divided by its magnitude. So R vector here I have written, it is equal to R I cap cos theta plus J cap sin theta divided by this R. This is cancelled with this. I can write ER cap is equal to I cap cos theta plus J cap sin theta. Now similarly, I can write E theta cap, as we know, x-axis, y-axis and z-axis, the three mutually, all the three coordinate axes, they are mutually perpendicular to each other. So similarly, we can write E theta cap is perpendicular to ER cap. So I can write, this will be equal to minus I cap, what can I write here? Cos 90 plus theta minus I cap sin theta plus J cap cos theta. Right? So these are the values of the unit vectors in plane polar coordinates. Now making use of all this, I will be able to derive the expression for velocity of a particle in plane polar, in terms of plane polar coordinates. So let us see how I will write all this. Now again, by the definition of expression for velocity,
Now we know velocity can be written as v is equal to dr by dt. As usual, we are writing this is equal to rate of change of displacement. Or I can write it this v vector. This is equal to r vector dot. This is the dot representation of velocity. This is equal to d by dt of r into er cap. Because vector r can be written as vector r. See here, vector r is equal to magnitude of r or simple r into er cap. Right? Now what I have to do? D by dt of r into er cap. U into v. Apply the formula and let us do the differentiation. How I will do? First function as it is, d by dt of second function er cap plus second function as it is, d by dt of first r. Right? So I can write this as r. D by dt of er cap, er cap dot. See here, er cap dot plus er cap. What can I write for this? This is equal to r dot. Now look here in this expression. I am okay with this er cap, r cap. Let us rewrite it again. Can I write it er cap dot? Better to write it like this. That is unit vectors here at the end. So I am okay with this expression. What about this? Here I have to find, I know the value of er cap. Now the value of er cap already written, I cap cos theta plus j cap sin theta. In order to find er cap dot, that is d by dt of er cap, I have to do the differentiation of this. So how can I write? That is er cap dot can be written as d by dt of I cap cos theta plus j cap sin theta. Now let us do the differentiation. So I can write it. So this is equal to I cap sin theta differentiation minus cos theta minus sin theta. Right? Into d theta by dt. Into d theta by dt. Plus j cap into sin theta. It will be cos theta into d theta by dt. So, what can I write further? So, I can write it like this also. That is E R cap dot. This will be equal to this d theta by dt, d theta by dt. I can take it out of the bracket sign. So I can write it theta dot minus I cap sin theta plus j cap cos theta. Now see guys, what is this? Minus I cap sin theta plus j cap cos theta. What is this here? Compare it with this. What is this? This is e theta cap. So can I write for this? E theta cap. Right? So see in my actual equation, let us suppose this is my equation number 1. Substituting the value of er cap dot in equation number 1. So what can I write? Here what was I doing? I was writing the expression for velocity in plane polar coordinates. So I can write, substituting the value in equation number 1, I can write r dot er cap. I am okay with this term. Here I have to substitute the value of er cap dot. So what can I write? Plus r er cap dot is
theta dot a theta cap. Right? So this is the required expression for velocity of a particle in terms of plane polar coordinates. Now see guys, I can write in terms of component. Let us suppose this component is represented by Vr and this second component is V theta. Now this is the Vr, this component, and this is the V theta component. Now this Vr component is known as radial component of velocity. This component is known as radial component of velocity. That is Vr. Radial component of velocity is r dot er cap. And this second is known as transverse component of velocity. That is V theta. Transverse component of velocity r theta dot into e theta cap. Now what will be the magnitude of velocity? That is how we can write the magnitude of velocity, which can be written as mod V is equal to r dot square plus r theta dot square root. As we were writing previously in Cartesian coordinate system, magnitude of velocity mod V vector was equal to x square plus y square root. Similarly, here we can write r dot square from here we can write r square theta dot square. So this is how, or you can write, represent it like this also, r square plus v theta square, one and the same thing. So this is the magnitude of velocity. So this was all about for today's lecture, and tomorrow in the further lecture, next we will write the expression for acceleration in plane polar coordinates. Thank you very much.